The world moves pretty fast. One minute you're standing, the next you're dragging. How can you keep up? I'll tell you. I'm Ira Madison III, host of Keep It. Each week, Louis Vertel, Aida Osman, and I do the hard work of exploring the intersection between entertainment, culture, and politics with guests like Billy Porter, Catherine O'Hara, Ronan Farrow, Francesca Ramsey, and more. New episodes of Keep It drop every Wednesday. Listen on Odyssey, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
What's up, everyone? I'm Carmelo Anthony. And while you may know me as a basketball player, there's a whole lot more I'm ready to talk about. That's why I started What's in Your Glass, a show where we'll sit down for a glass of wine and a conversation with the biggest names in sports, music, media, and entertainment. Listen and follow What's in Your Glass, a presentation of Cadence 13 and Creative 7 with me, Carmelo Anthony, now for free on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Odyssey, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Welcome back. Oh, man, later in the hour, Rhea Hughes has made a major television discovery.
Yes.
And our TV guy, Jay Blackow, will review it because he's already seen it.
Nice.
And it is based in the city of Philadelphia.
It's awesome.
Yeah, she loves it. Yep. We got the hot seat coming up, and we got one of the most impressive men we know. His name is Andrew Brandt. And I believe he has, what is it, Rhea?
He's got a tweet. So his tweet out is, he retweeted NBC News, and it said, the tweet from NBC News, New York City could see between 2 inches and 20 inches of snow this weekend. So Andrew retweeted it and said, your grade is between an A and an F.
On the line from Villanova, Andrew Brandt. Hi, Andrew.
Hey, Angela, I love that tweet. The meteorologist must love that. The key to success is vagueness, right?
Absolutely. Andrew, I know that people can follow you on a variety of sites. How can people follow your tweets and your other great
work? Your newsletter,
Yeah, the tweet is my name, Andrew Brandt, but the newsletter is andrew-brandt.com. And I started a news site just for people that want even more of me. And, yes, I'm trying to monetize it a little bit. So, andrew-brandt.com/SBL. That's for Sports Business League. So if you want my daily views, join the Sports Business League.
Sports Business League. Okay, Andrew, I just got to know this because I know you remain a great Aaron Rodgers fan, but I also know that you are not in favor of people who will not get the vaccine. How have you been able to rationalize this yourself?
You know, it's been interesting, Angela, because I have known him since draft day 2005. I think if people can just put aside the vaccine stuff, and I know it's polarizing, and I know he brings it on himself, but I have always thought and continue to think he's one of the most thoughtful athletes we've had in our generation, where he can go on and wax about a lot of things. Where, how many times do we ever see that in sports, where someone's not in a press conference setting or just talking about the cliches and the all-for-one speak? And I like that he's been introspective and thoughtful, and I know it's hard for people to separate the antagonistic stuff that comes out of his mouth about vaccines. So the way I do it is I accept him for what he is. I understand he can cause a lot of damage with those comments. I'm against those comments. If I was advising him, I'd tell him to stay away from that. But I understand who he is. And I think what we have to do with Aaron is just say, okay, he is who he is. He's given these forums, whether Pat McAfee, ESPN, NFL Network. And what do we want him to do? We want him to just go back to cliches like all the other athletes, or we want him to talk? As long as people have given him these runways, he's going to be honest.
Andrew, I'm very curious on this next day because you helped to bring him to Green Bay.
Yeah.
Has he played his last game at Lambeau Field? Is that it for him?
Angel, I've said this for 2 years. I've said that he would play in 2021 when everyone said, well, maybe he'll never come back. He's upset. And that he will be traded in 2022. I just remember that image from draft night 2020 with the draft where everyone's in their basements with their kids. And Matt LaFleur and Brian Gutekunst had these smiles ear to ear after they traded up to get Jordan Love, kind of like we did with Aaron Rodgers, although we weren't that thrilled because we didn't expect to be drafting a quarterback. And I'm like, okay, so when's the transition? I think it's 2 years. Now, Aaron sat for three, I get it, but no one has sat anywhere near that. Mahomes sat a year, Trey Lance a year. I just don't see them going into third year with Love on the bench. And I think Aaron's introspective comments favoring his time in Lambeau Field and those kind of things only add to my thoughts there.
So he goes to Denver with his offensive coordinator, Hackett?
The dots seem there for that. That seems logical. A lot happening in the last 24 hours that would make you think there. Listen, Denver has been a rumored destination for Aaron for a year. And now they hire not only his offensive coordinator, his coach, his confidant, maybe his best friend on the team. It would seem logical. And if so, Angela, we'll get to the local team, but that team has played it really well in my mind. They have had MVP performance, and they're going to get a bounty of compensation for him while continuing their plan to move to the future.
Yeah, it is encouraging in that way. Andrew, before we get to the coaching hunts that are going on, including names we're very familiar with, the Packers lost because of a complete breakdown of special teams.
Yeah.
Would you fire the special teams coach based on how that season ended?
You hate to do this, you know, but yes.
You would. Wow.
The answer is yes. I mean, I'm still a fan because of my time there and my kids' time there. But listen, I was as shocked as anyone. I thought, okay, this is the team. And you know what? When you're in the business, and I was in the business 10 years, you know sometimes where you got the team. Sometimes you have the team and you're like, yeah, we can make the playoffs, but we're not a Super Bowl team. And we had the team a couple times. One time ended here with that 4th-and-26 game. And I know. And one time, and I just felt like this year, they had the team. They got the bye. They're playing a team from California in sub-zero temps. They got a defense this year. They've got the best quarterback, the best receiver. I'm like, okay, it's the year. It's all set up. So I totally underestimated the value of special teams, which clearly lost them the game.
Yeah.
And, yes, he would be sacrificed.
All right, let me get to there's something that's really I can't get my arms around it. Hopefully you're going to help me with this. Jonathan Gannon was here 1 year as a defense coordinator. It's his first year anywhere in the NFL as a coordinator. I wasn't at all impressed. He is a hot name in the coaching circuit. Doug Peterson won a Super Bowl here and did it with dignity and class. He is not at all a hot name. Please explain.
I don't know if I have any special insights here. I think people that evaluate coaches do it in a number of different ways. They talk to people they know. They talk to people they like. They talk to their network. And they can talk to these consultants out there, like a Charlie Cassidy, like a Bill Polian, even my old boss, Ron Wolf. And somehow these names get churned up. I also wouldn't underestimate the value of agents that are constantly pushing guys out there and serving their clients' needs with the media. And maybe what you read in the media is not actually true, that these guys are hot names or not. But I don't know what the analysis of someone like Gannon's work goes into in terms of, okay, we like the scheme he runs, maybe he hasn't had the success, but look how he did against this game and look how he did against this defense, and he's got the personnel that we have. So it's all wrapped up in that. I don't know the answer on Doug, too. I'm partial to Doug. I've known him for 20 years. And we just heard about Jacksonville, and like you said, we haven't heard anything beyond that.
It's an amazing thing. Last thing, Andrew, I only come to you because you have better answers than I do. Why is football so much more popular than any other sport?
Yeah, and it's not even close. I mean, to average 37 million last weekend and average 17 million for the season, you know, the World Series and NBA Finals are like 9 million. It's just like amazing to me. It's such a television product, the uniforms, the unison of the lines. It's so packaged. for that. And, I mean, I lived in Europe for a while where soccer's kind of ingrained in young people's veins at age five. And it almost seems like NFL's like that here. It just becomes cultural and generational. And, by the way, last thing, sports betting's a big part of it, too.
Oh, without a doubt. That's where at the Borgata. Andrew Brandt, we are constantly, constantly dazzled by your knowledge. Thank you so much, as always, Andrew. Thanks.
Always a pleasure, guys.
Andrew Brandt with some great thoughts. He's also like the director of Villanova Law.
Director of Sports Law and Monday Morning Quarterback.
The guy's unbelievable, Al. And everything he does is more intelligent than we do.
Well, it's beyond that. He's smart.
Yeah.
What are you saying? We're dummies?
Yeah.
We must be. We get up very early.
Yeah.
That's all I'm thinking. All right, Mike is up. Butch has prepared a poem on Keith Jones winning all that money. But first, here's Mike. Hi, Mike. Mike, I guess we have lost Mike.
Yeah, he's talking to somebody else.
I will try Pat next. Hi, Rodney. Hi, Rodney.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
What's going on, Rod? What are you feeling this morning?
Man, like, it's like, I don't know what to think about the Sixers because it's just like, I see what I see as far as, like, the people that stepped up, but it's just like, It's not gonna do nothing. Once we go to the playoffs, because it's just like we still missing some pieces. And the fact that Ben Simmons is still here, because Daryl Morey is so in love with James Harden, it's just like I don't even know what to think. Like it's just like you know, we win these games that we supposed to win, and it's just like okay, that's fine. But it's just like I'm still not excited for this season. Like we're not gonna go nowhere if we don't make no moves.
I think you're reading it exactly right, 100% right. And I believe that the block right now is that Morey is fixated on Harden.
Yeah.
And you know, I guess he must think he's going to get him at the end of the year. But Harden's going to be at the back end of his career by then, Rod. And Embiid, do we have any way of knowing that Embiid's going to have three more great healthy years like this one? Why am I throwing this one away?
You can't.
I mean, I can't. They're not beating Bucks in seven games. They're not beating the Nets in seven games. Yeah, they're not doing it.
But at this point, I completely flipped. You have to stay now because Embiid's that good. He looks that good. He looks that healthy.
There's no way to know he can still be that good for this window that's going to be very narrow with Harden. Yeah, 2 years maybe? Two?
But who are you going to get that you're going to win it this year?
That I can't tell you. Well, but I'm with Rodney. I got an asset on my bench who won't play and is bringing nothing to me, and I'm just going to let a year go by. Yeah. Who's going to want Ben next year?
Do you know that two players in the NBA actually voted him to the All-Star game?
They did. Well, they're just
jackasses.
Stupid.
So if you're Brooklyn and you flame out this year and you have a lot of guys, I've said this from the beginning, it's the best fit for each team.
You think Ben fits good there?
Yeah.
I doubt it. Rodney, I don't want anything to do with Ben. I can't stand him.
You and me both. Like it's to the point that it's hard to even watch this team because it's just like, you know, it's only like I know for sure Embiid is going to play good, but it's just like the players on that team is inconsistent. You know, like he don't really have a partner, like a Batman Robin, like, you know, like Maxie is still young, like, you know, he's still like improving, like, you know, Tobias Harris, who I think is win of the week, you know, like he played good this week.
Yeah. Tobias Harris for your winner.
No.
I gotta keep it moving, Rob, but thank you very much for the call. 215-592-9494. Do you have this poem ready, Butch? Do you want to do it right now? Because Keith Jones won over $15,000 here at the Borgata.
$16,000,
whatever it was, $16,000. Did you write a poem as C. Wright threw it?
Yes, I did, Angelo. And Jonesy, $16,000. The inspiration was I won $18,000 at Harris at a bad beat 6 years ago on April Fool's Day.
All right, that's a long time ago. I don't even think that place is here anymore. We're really only talking about Borgata here, Butch, all right?
Okay, Angelo.
Yeah. Go ahead.
You ready? Okay. Yeah. Sweet 16 by C. Wright threw it. The rich get rich and the poor get poorer. And with the Flyers, Jonesy wasn't much of a scorer. But he scored real big the other day when he got a $16,000 win on a $3.50 spin. The bells and whistles went off, it's safe to say, but Jonesy thought it was from all the hits in the head he took back in the day. Then after he got back his composure, he received a $16,000 check for closer. He took out a brunch, but I got a hunch. He really doesn't spend a bunch. And how about Angelo and the rest of the crew? Didn't he realize they were hungry too?
Yeah.
He sent out a video to show off his winnings. He's come a long way from his humble beginnings. So congratulations, Josie. You're real affluent. But all the high rollers down the Borgata can
see right through it.
Bingo.
I don't know how you do it. How do you do it? Do you walk around all day with rhymes in your head?
Kind of like that, Angel. I'm really like kind of playing cards, and I'm rhyming like win and sin and all
you
this.
You do that
up
right through the when you're playing cards.
Yeah, yeah. Everything's always stuff popping in my head, Angel.
You know, that's the way short songwriters do it,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, yeah. Just you get a, you
they
know.
They hear a jingle in there.
You got to go out there around people, though, to get these experiences that you can think about them even. You know what I mean? You can't sit in the house and make up this stuff.
I hope you understand that among the callers, you are a hero to me.
Angelo, I hope you understand that you're most one of the honest guys that has ever worked at this radio station.
Bingo.
That's a lie.
Thank you very much. 215. Would you shut up? We were having a moment. 215-592-9494. WIP Sports Time 917.
You want a new look for your kitchen or bathroom? Colonial Marble and Granite can make that happen. I recently completed my new kitchen renovation with the help from Colonial Marble and Granite. I absolutely love it. They installed my tile floor, countertops, backsplash. Start with a stop into one of their area showrooms. You will be absolutely blown away by their selection of stone slabs. Select the exact stone slab that will become your countertops from the nation's largest selection. Their professional sales team will help you choosing the right countertop material, style, and color. Their expert team, they handle the whole project from the on-site fabrication to installation. They can also help, like they did with me, coordinating the backsplash and floor tile. Get started building your dream kitchen and bathroom with help from Colonial Marble and Granite. Get a fully installed quartz, marble, or granite countertop for just $14.99 or zero money down with 0% financing on purchases of $19.99 or more. For details, visit one of their local showrooms or colonialmarble.net. Brought to you by PDC Baseball. Sixers over the Lakers last night at the Wells Fargo Center, 105-87. They did not have LeBron James for the Lakers as they ruled him out about 90 minutes prior to the game due to knee soreness. Joel Embiid, 26 points, 9 rebounds, and 7 assists. With the game being broadcast nationally on TNT, it gave Shaquille O'Neal the opportunity to blast Ben Simmons. And he took it, called Simmons Embiid's soft partner, adding he doesn't respect him. Coaches, are you scheduling your 2022 baseball tournaments now? Experience the refreshing difference of PDC baseball tournaments at pdcbaseball.com. NBC 10 First Alert Forecast. Snow showers, a high of 37. Winter storm warning from 7 p.m. to 7 p.m. tomorrow. 4 to 11 inches possible. It's currently 31. To stream 94WIP, go to the all-new 94WIP.com.
So, you have a new smart speaker or a connected device.
No matter what device you have, Odyssey has something you'll love.
Blast your favorite music on home entertainment devices like Roku, Chromecast, Sonos, and more.
Just look for the Odyssey app.
Want to access more stations through your car?
Try out Odyssey with Waze or Apple CarPlay. Plus, listen to your favorite stations on your phone with the Odyssey app.
Listen to Odyssey anytime on all your smart speakers and connected devices.
Odyssey.
Odyssey. Odyssey.
Hey, it's David Spade.
And Dana Carvey here. Join us for our new podcast, Fly on the Wall. Every week, we're going to catch up with an alum from the world of SNL.
Our old buddies like Chris Rock, Tina Fey, Tom Hanks, Martin Short, Kevin Nealon, and many more. They'll join and talk SNL from the days on the show and the days how they got on the show. Mm-hmm.
Follow and listen to Fly on the Wall, a presentation of Cadence 13. Available now for free on the Odyssey app or wherever you listen to your podcasts. Man, I'm getting good.
Not available in any countries.
No joke, folks.
That was pretty good.
What's a firefighter without a fire truck? Our first responders need reliable equipment. So if you're a mechanic, technician, fabricator, or an assembler, our first responders need you. E1 in Hamburg will give you everything you need to succeed in your career. Tools, full benefits starting from day one, great pay, 401k match, vacations and holidays, and growth opportunities. Register for our on-site hiring event on Thursday, February 17th from 4 to 7 p.m. Visit E1NY.com. That's E-O-N-E-N-Y.com.
Scotch Neat is one of my outlets, another outlet of mine, saving money. I can satisfy both outlets at Outlet Liquor. While other wine and liquor stores do weekly ads with a few items on sale to grab you, at Outlet Liquor, you never have to wait for a sale. You always get the best prices, genuine outlet prices, every day on the wines and spirits you enjoy. So skip the sale ads, save big every day when you stock up at the place to buy a case, Outlet Liquor, just minutes from the airport, George Urban, near Dick Road, Depew.
.924 from Borgata on a Friday morning. Thrilled to be back, by the way. And Al, I got to tell you something. I think it's over. I think that, you know, what's kept us away the last few weeks was that Omicron thing.
I'm starting to think I'm getting a good feeling now
that we are out of the woods.
That's it. That's the final word.
Yeah.
Is that it?
That's it. Somebody alert.
I don't need Fauci. I have Dr. Cataldi.
Yeah.
When we are here, ladies and gentlemen, we do not consult at all with Miss Ava Graham.
No.
Yes.
Therefore, she does whatever she wants on Fridays with the hot seat. Let's all join together and find out if we agree with Ava Graham.
I think you're going to agree with me on this one. Today, LeBron James is on the hot seat. Brought to you by Xfinity, the fastest internet in Philadelphia, and the sponsor of WIP's Xfinity Lounge. Hot seat. LeBron, people paid a lot of money to come see you last night.
Put $25,000 down and didn't get to see LeBron?
Right, right. We all wanted to see LeBron.
Then you announced right before the game you're not playing because of knee soreness?
Here comes the alert. LeBron out with the bad knee. Ain't this something? I just wanted to go home at that point. I just wanted to go home.
This may be the only chance. For some of those people that bought those tickets, they don't have the money to pay that every year. This was their chance, and he woke up with knee soreness. Brian, that's bull.
You know what? I'm adding someone else to the hot seat. It's now Sofa. Because I think that lame-o, Rich Paul, had something to do with it.
Rich Paul is also the agent of LeBron James. Ben Simmons doesn't want to play in front of Philadelphia. Rich Paul got LeBron not to play to punish Philadelphia for what we did to Ben Simmons.
I think you're onto something, Ange.
Is it fathomable? Is it possible?
It's fathomable, but I would say that's a level of evil genius that I don't know that it is.
I don't trust that Rich Paul, especially after the Adele situation. And you know what? I'm adding Adele to that sofa, too. What are you doing with him? You deserve better. It's not okay, but I still love you.
No. That was the real Adele. I like the other Adele.
Yes. Yeah.
I like the other Adele who earlier this week, Al, covered Adele.
Yes, very well.
But I am not putting Ava on the couch.
No.
Ava. But I am putting Adele on there because she distracted Rich Paul, and then he got angry, and then he told LeBron to sit. That's our story, and we're sticking to it.
You are right, brother.
Hello.
Oh, gosh.
Adele. Rich Paul destroyed the Sixers. Don't let him get you down. Hello. Adele. Your fans paid stupid money to see you sing aloud. So don't let this relationship ruin all the fun. Hello from Philly. Ben could never shoot a three. And I'm sorry, Adele, for singing your song, but you need to get out before more damage is done. Hello from Philly. Ben Simmons' free throws are scary. Please, Adele, run from before he screws up your career like he's screwing our team.
There you have it.
Yes.
On the couch today, LeBron James, Rich Paul, and yes, Adele.
I got that.
Hell of a couch.
Yeah, that's a couch.
I have a new toy.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, this is what it is. I love it.
I love it.
I like all that. Was very nice of you to send me over the emails of people
no,
saying
I
nice
got
things.
All good ones.
It was mostly, I got a lot of very nice feedback yesterday.
No,
so
no
will,
one, everyone no. likes it. You know this never happens. There wasn't one email that said you were not a great singer and could sing Adele.
I played it for my brother and he goes, is that Ava? And I go, yeah. And he goes, wow.
Yes.
He's stunned.
We don't know why you're still with us. You should be on tour.
I don't know why either, but, you know.
It's a valid question.
Because, you know, you know what? Whatever. Whatever you want me to do, yeah. I'm just,
that, by the
I'm
way,
a
that
puppet,
was, that
and
was
I'm
the
here.
Correct, that was the correct hot seat, too, today. Yes.
Thank
a
you.
Very good job,
Thank
Ava.
You very much.
Let's go to Art. Pat. I'm sorry, Pat. Good morning.
Good morning. I mean, between Butch and his poem and Ava's song, I mean, well, I got nothing. I
we
got
present,
nothing.
All you need to do is provide your opinion. You are the core of this show, and that other stuff is like all the extra ornaments.
Bingo. I guess that's why you're retiring soon, if I'm the core of this radio show.
We'll find out in a minute. What do you got to say today, Pat?
I was going with... The Weasel of the Week, I was going with Major League Baseball. Did I miss something? They're keeping out two of the greatest players in Major League Baseball because of steroids. David, you're telling me David Ortiz wasn't sipping on some juice? Just because he didn't get caught, the moral compass of Major League Baseball, the most corrupt sports entity there is from day one, is keeping out these people and putting in other people because they didn't get convicted. I don't know. I enjoy baseball. I can watch baseball. I enjoy. I self-medicate, so 3.5 hours of just nothing doesn't bother me. But
very good, Pat. All right, Pat. Let me see if I get Al's feedback on this.
Yeah,
Al, he's saying that it's hypocritical what baseball did with those star players.
Well, it wasn't Major League Baseball.
Oh, okay. But that would be one if he named the proper people.
I guess
the voters.
Get some consideration, but no, there's better weasel. Right, but
we
no,
can't take it, Pat. But I were, think you they, did a good
this,
thing with that.
At this
that.
Point, the writers just should stop.
All right, I wasn't here Wednesday when we hear construction work. Is that Kurt Schilling?
Yes, that's Kurt Schilling. Yeah. Yes.
Is there a ferret in there somewhere?
Yeah, the ferret's going to bite him soon.
Right, there is.
Ow!
All right, there you go. Okay.
Well, right, probably so, when Joe's in, the ferret will call to complain to
No,
to
I'm
Schilling.
Sure it
yeah.
will. No, but Kurt Schilling did not make the Hall of Fame, but now he is working.
Well, he asked
with
for his
ferret.
Name to be taken out last year.
No,
remember?
I understand yeah. that. They didn't take it
they
out.
They didn't take it out.
And then
no.
they voted him out.
Yes.
That to me that seems better. I like that better.
God.
Jerry is up for Wilmington. Hi, Jerry.
Good morning. Good morning. Hey, I got snow outside. Jeez, I can't believe. I thought it was.
Yeah, I'm
snow
very
today.
Nervous now because I'm waiting for my driver Bernadette from Global Limousine, but I don't know if she could drive in the snow out.
She's a professional pro. Driver.
It's a Lincoln Town Car.
Well, you're
It'll
old.
Be fine.
Yeah.
What do you mean? Yeah, I'm old? anyway, go ahead, Jerry.
I didn't know Aaron Rodgers made $46 million and Hurts makes $2 million. That's 23 times more than Hurts. They both yeah. That's a lot of money. That's an unbelievable amount of money. I didn't realize
have you watched them
that
play?
Much.
Yeah, but Rodgers makes so much now, I think he can afford to go to a Sixers game.
That's who's down there.
Unbelievable. So,
Jerry, did you hear that somebody paid $25,000 for 4 tickets last night to a Sixers game?
Is that true? I heard that.
It's 100% true. Somebody paid $25,000 and he didn't play.
Yeah.
is that through Wells Fargo or is that StubHub or what?
I'm guessing StubHub, secondary market, LeBron, huge item, your court side.
Yeah.
Yeah, it all adds up. That's probably yeah. it's 4. There were 2 for $10,000
what a bargain.
And 2 for $2,500
a
piece.
That's a bargain.
That's $25,000.
Somebody's got a lot of extra money. That's unbelievable.
Wow. All right, Jerry, we need a weasel.
Okay. Well, I'm torn between my American model and my European model.
He's doing the weather thing, Al. Come on, Jerry. Give it to me.
I'm going to go for the guy or girl who doesn't know how to spell Julius Ivan.
Oh, good one.
That's a good one. That's not it.
Not it?
But
it's,
we don't even know the name, but that's
how
a bad day.
How do you
day.
Not know how to spell the
it's
name of one of your greatest players ever?
I guess
will the Sixers come out with a statement today?
No.
No, it's just somebody made a mistake.
Made a mistake. Maybe he's 24 years old or something.
Would you like it if they said they promoted you out of WIP website as Al Norganti?
Wouldn't bother me.
It would bother me.
It wouldn't bother me. Usually, my first name is easy.
That's true.
Al, two letters. No waiting. Let's go to Nancy in Valley Forge next. Hi, Nance.
Hey, how are you?
I'm great, Nancy. How are you today?
I'm well. Hey, you know, I listen to you guys from literally 6:30 in the morning when I get up until Johnny and I call it a day at 6 o'clock at night.
Nice.
That's
and
awesome.
nowhere during the day have I heard anybody come up with in talking about the coaching. You know, we got Gannon who can't coach a defense, but yet he's all over the place for head coaching jobs. But then we have Deuce, who was here for how many years doing, and he's not mentioned anywhere. So what gives? Is it just, you know, who you know? Is it because Deuce says what he thinks? Like, I just don't get it. And
that
granted,
he was completely with a team. Forgot Deuce. Nancy.
He's with a team that didn't do anything this year, and that's not necessarily his fault. But we run him out of town. I don't know. It just makes me mad.
Well, it should make you mad. I'm going to tell you something, and I know this is completely ridiculous, mm-hmm. but I believe it. If Deuce had been hired instead of Nick Sirianni, the Eagles would possibly still be playing because they would have run the ball from day one.
Yeah.
That was their strength. They would have won some of those early games that they lost. They would have finished with a significantly better record.
You mean they
record.
Wouldn't have run the ball only three times in the first Dallas
and
game?
But, Nancy, you said it. I think you said it in the middle of that. It's not really what you know. It's who you know.
Yeah.
And if you get somehow, Andrew Brandt was saying, there are consultants. There are people that promote names.
There's a list.
If you're not on their list.
You are screwed.
What do you need to do to get on that damn list?
I don't know.
That's
the question. How do you get into this network of candidates when we don't? The Indy defensive coordinator got a job as a head coach. Based on what?
Well,
1 year?
Eberflus.
1 year. I never heard the guy's name. He's a head coach.
Exactly.
Eberflus.
Yeah.
So, I don't get it.
Deuce needs, you know, just because Deuce isn't part of the old boys club that run all
these
teams.
Actually,
I mean, I don't want to make it about something, but it's hard to
say it's
not.
I don't know that it's racial. I do know that it's who you know. I'm pretty sure you're right. Nancy, I need a winner or weasel, please. I'm running out of time.
I don't have anything. I'm good. I just want to say, listen, we're going to miss you when you're gone. And not only are we going to miss you when you're gone because you're you, but the memories I have of waking up in the mornings as a kid and coming downstairs and my dad listening to WIP and you.
Nancy, I got to be honest.
You're part of our family.
I've woken up with a lot of women over the years. See you later, Nancy.
And men too.
Yeah.
All
right.
Like
why did you have to ruin it? I was trying to. I don't know how to use this thing yet, Al.
I got a lot of time to learn.
Yeah, it's really difficult. You hit it with your finger.
What is that?
You're punching it.
It's a touchpad.
What is it called?
It's a touchscreen.
That's called the touchscreen.
But you're not supposed to try to put your finger through it like the Three Stooges guy.
My God.
215. Al, I'm not that smooth. When we come back, Jay Black is going to tell you about a brand new show. Based in Philly.
Yes.
And he's going to give some numbers on the greatest playoff weekend in NFL history.
Wow.
That's next. WIP Sports Time is 9:37. Now let me tell you about Borgata, because Borgata Sports welcomes you to their app with a special offer on the NBA. Just place a $10 wager on any game, and you're going to receive $200 in free bets regardless of your bet's outcome. Yep. Just use the bonus code WIP200 when you make that first bet. BetMGM is proud to be an authorized gaming partner of the NBA. Download the app or go to BorgataSports.com. Use the bonus code WIP200 to receive $200 of free bets when you place a $10 wager on any NBA game. Find out why New Jersey basketball fans love Borgata Sports.
Hey, I'm the voice of the Instagram account Demois. Or maybe I'm not. You'll never know, and I'll never tell. What I can tell you is, I have a new podcast called Do You. Demois is an anonymous Instagram page that features stories about Hollywood that no one else is discussing. The podcast will provide you with exclusive information that is not found anywhere else, including Instagram. Listen to Do You, a podcast from Cadence 13, now on the Odyssey app or wherever you listen to your podcasts.
What's a firefighter without a fire truck? Our first responders need reliable equipment. So if you're a mechanic, technician, fabricator, or an assembler, our first responders need you. E1 in Hamburg will give you everything you need to succeed in your career. Tools, full benefits starting from day one, great pay, 401k match, vacations and holidays, and growth opportunities. Register for our on-site hiring event on Thursday, February 17th from 4 to 7 p.m. Visit e1ny.com. That's E-O-N-E-N-Y.com.
Hey, David Bellavia here. Just because your existing bathroom has a tub, that doesn't mean you're stuck with it. Bathfitter can remove your old tub and convert it to a shower in one day. Think of how much safer your bathroom will be if you don't have to step in and out of a slippery high wall tub when you convert it to a shower. Don't wait. Call Bathfitter now at 242-8999 and book your free consultation and get up to $1,000 off or no interest financing until 2027. Call Bathfitter at 242-8999.
Hi, this is Mike, apprentice with Local 22 Plumbers and Steam Fitters. Career options are heating up for HVAC service experts. Apply for paid training and become a union HVAC expert. Earn a pension, life insurance, and even family health coverage while you're in training.
Stop by 120 Gardenville Parkway this Tuesday between 9 and 5. For details, text Local 22 to 20357. Text and data rates may apply. Earn while you learn. Join the union. UA Plumbers and Steam Fitters Local 22 encourages you to always hire union.
All right, welcome back, 942. We have been telling you all week that what we witnessed last weekend was the greatest NFL playoff weekend in history. Al, some of the top people we've had on have all said that was the greatest ever.
Back to back to back to back.
How good were the numbers? Let's bring on our TV guy. He's also an accomplished stand-up comic, the great Jay Black from jblack.tv. Hi, Jay. Oh, I got to hit the button.
I'm going to try that Preva thing.
Right, it doesn't work all the time when you hit it. Hi, Jay.
Hello, Angelo. How are you?
I'm using a touchpad and not well. All right, Jay, that was sensational, four games. How great were the TV ratings for those games?
So a couple of records on these. Number one, just to let you know, put this in perspective. The average for all four games was 38 million. So those 16 hours of TV, if it were one TV show, would be the third highest rated TV show of 2021. That's how many people were watching all together. The biggest game, of course, was the Kansas City game. 42.7 million people watched on average. But at peak, at the end of that game, it got up to about 52 million people were watching.
Wow.
One of the highest rated games of the last 7 years for the NFL.
52 million, Jay. It saw the last couple of minutes when it kept switching back. You can't buy that kind of an audience anymore.
No. I mean, it's phenomenal. And it's not just that game. Rams Chiefs was 38 million. That's the highest NBC rated game other than the Super Bowl since they got the NFL back in 2006.
Wow.
49ers Packers 37 million. That's the highest rated Saturday playoff game since the current format was adopted in 2002. And Bengals Titans 30 million. That's the highest Saturday afternoon game in 7 years. So the numbers, just the number of people watching, people I think sort of instinctively knew that this was going to be one of the greatest football weekends ever.
All right, Al raised the question before. I know we don't have local numbers on this, but I need an explanation. The Philadelphia 76ers were booked to play a basketball game in the midst of those great games last Sunday. Why would the NBA do that, Jay? They know they have no chance.
I think the NBA for and the ratings numbers nationally back this up. I was able to pull the national NBA game for Sunday night was 200,000 people watched nationally, Angelo.
You're saying at the end of the football game was 52 million and 200,000 watched the NBA?
Nationally. It scored lower than the lowest rated soccer game of the weekend.
Wow. Oh, my
That's how much
goodness.
Football dominated it.
Wow.
So my thinking on the NBA is I think that they their ratings are done in an aggregate. I don't think that they sort of report their numbers game to game. That's why we can't find them. I think it's a situation where they have the schedule locked out and they follow it regardless, because at the end of the year, it's an aggregate number and not a game-to-game number that gets them revenue.
All right, Jay, I consider myself a TV buff of my own, and Rhea pantsed me this morning. She comes in absolutely gushing about a new show called Abbott Elementary that is based in Philly. You said you have seen it. Could you tell us what you think of this?
I agree with Rhea. I think it's a fantastic show. Angela, I can't remember. Are you a fan of The Office or not?
I love The Office.
Okay, so this is the best way to describe this is it is The Office set in an elementary school.
Yeah.
Nice.
It's a documentary. It's a Philadelphia elementary school about an inner city school. It's written, created by, and starring this woman, Quinta Brunson. So this is basically a one-woman show.
She's from West Philly.
Okay.
Yeah, from West Philadelphia, and it is a very funny and heartwarming show, but it's not sentimental. A lot of these TV shows about teachers are, you know, the music comes up and the teacher is the savior. They don't do that. This is a very down-to-earth show.
Jay, I don't know if you know the principal. I didn't know this about her, who I think is an absolute riot. Janelle James, she's a stand-up comic. I was watching some of her stuff last night.
Yeah.
She's very funny.
Did they get Philadelphia right? See, if they don't get Philadelphia right, it's a Philadelphia show, I can't watch it.
So, you know, Rhea, back me up on this. I think they have elements of Philly, but they don't make it a Philly show.
The Eagles were kind of involved, like they mentioned in the beginning. They have it's a predominantly African-American cast. But one of the teachers is presenting as South Philly. She puts the accent on a little thick, but I do love her. But she always, to help the kids get what they need, because it's underfunded, I know a guy. Got a guy who can get us rugs.
But it's
really well done. I love it.
Well, people may be trapped in their houses with the snow. Watch Abbott Elementary this week.
And it's not just me, Ange. It's the first ABC comedy to premiere to quadruple ratings.
Whoa.
Yeah.
ABC. Yep. It's a network show.
It's a network show.
Jay Black, thank you, sir, as always.
Thank you, guys. Have a great weekend. Stay safe in the snow.
Oh, yeah.
Jay Black.
Bill and I are watching it
now,
too,
listen,
Ange.
You judges. These guys are tough. Mm-hmm. Are you ready now?
Can
we give some prizes away?
Yeah.
Sure.
You got the prizes at Friday.
Yeah.
All you got to do is pick a weasel.
Yes.
Rhea, I know you got Embiid in the background in case you don't get one. But somebody's got to beat Travis Kelce or Doc Rivers.
It is somebody from one of the games last weekend.
It's from somebody from the games last weekend. Mm. We're going rapid fire for four great prizes. Mike is on the line next. Hi, Mike.
Hey, how y'all doing? Can you hear me?
I'm doing great, Mike. What are you doing?
Hey, I'm listening to y'all and enjoying the thing. Hey, listen, I wanted to talk about the Eagles. Their quarterback situation, I think they'll be all right as long as they just put people around Jalen Hurts.
All right.
But on the racial, the editor on how the guy said it, like, you know what I mean? Goes,
right. He said little
black
boy.
Man don't want to hear that.
Mike, if somebody calls an African-American a little boy, is that racial?
Well, he said he called him a little boy, but you never know how, you know, Anthony took it. But
I guess.
My thing is, it's like, look, fans should be able to say what they want. I don't think LeBron took off because Rich Paul, because he's such a competitor. I believe he wanted the show. So I believe he was truly hurt.
Maybe. Could be right, Mike. We don't know, but
we're speculating.
I always prefer a conspiracy theory. Mike, do you have a winner or weasel?
Yeah, I have to have the NFL divisional games. They were the best. I don't know if you can combine both of them, but that's
all
what
right,
I
was. NFL games.
No, it's a
not
specific person.
All right, here we go. This is going to be a disaster.
Why?
I got to do this with the touch thing.
Yeah,
all right,
just
you ready?
Don't try to put your finger through it. It's called touch, not
Scott
beat up.
Scott is up for Barrington. Scott, I need a winner or weasel. Who you got?
I'm going to say weasel from last night, that knucklehead LeBron James.
LeBron James has not been named till now. Al Morganti.
No, I'll give you a hint.
It's not to LeBron.
Mamma mia.
I don't know what he's saying. I got nothing. Sean's up from Maryland. Hi, Sean.
Hey, I got a winner.
Who's your winner?
Last name Willis for the 49ers knocked out Aaron Rodgers.
No,
not going to win, Sean. I got Bruce up from Atlantic City, Al.
He's going to get hit hard.
Mm. Hi, Bruce.
What's up, Angie? Guys, let's try Travis Kelce.
Travis Kelce is your winner?
No, that's your winner.
It's my winner, too, Bruce.
All right, let's go. Pat Mahomes.
Pat Mahomes
that's
is the winner.
No,
that's not the winner. He had a good winner, though, Al, because it was mine all morning.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go to Connor. Hi, Connor.
How are you doing? I just wanted to say Kevin Garnett regarded as the best trash talker amongst his peers in the NBA. And he said he never would ever say anything personal being about with family or anything like that, just strictly play. So
you cannot say to Carmelo that Meek Mill was dating Lala. Hmm.
Well, he's a fan, but he's like a big celebrity, so that kind of probably hurt a bit.
Well, I could just tell you, probably Kevin Garnett was not the best example to give since there was a massive beef with him and Carmelo Anthony.
That's right.
Because he supposedly said something really nasty about Lala.
Good information.
They always are still good.
I'm just saying.
Connor, I need a winner or weasel. Do you understand it's snowing out? Hurry up.
I'm driving on. It's not going to win, but Kendrick Perkins.
Kendrick Perkins is not going to win.
No.
All I have time for is a name. Nicholas, who's the winner?
I got Weasel and Brittany Mahomes.
Brittany Mahomes.
No, mine's a quarterback.
It's a quarterback.
Not playing anymore.
Karen, who is the Weasel?
Weasel, Rich Paul.
Rich Paul.
Didn't play quarterback.
I think I'm winning
Didn't
Weasel today. Frankie, I got two more and I win. Frankie, who you got?
Did you hit it? You haven't hit
I'm
it yet. Oh, there you go.
It's not going. Frankie, who you got?
Aaron Donald.
Aaron Donald.
No.
Last chance. Oh. I am going to win. Embiid will win.
Yeah,
the
Al,
winner.
Give a hint.
A quarterback that played
He had a gorgeous wife. Dan's the last one.
Probably, yeah.
We're not sure. Dan, who you got?
Winner, Evan McPherson, Bengals.
Wow, you got it.
He got it.
I can't believe you got it.
You got Evan McPherson. You won the winner. The weasel was unclaimed this week.
Jeff Garcia.
Jeff Garcia got into a big fight.
Oh, and it checked down the tweets.
Mina Kimes.
With Mina Kimes, and it was bad.
Listen, there's not an analyst on the planet last weekend or this past week who didn't say Jimmy Garoppolo played poorly.
Right, no.
McPherson, Edge, I gave it to him because – before his game-winning kick, he walked up to a couple of players and went, so I guess we're going to the AFC Championship game. Like, just completely calmly.
Wow.
I love that.
That's fair. Rhea likes confidence. Hmm. Al,
what did they
win?
They won a $50 Visa gift card, a $25 gift card to the official Eagles Pro Shop. They're everywhere. Lancaster, Cherry Hill, Lincoln Financial Field. 4-pack of tickets to see the Harlem Globetrotters spread game tour. That's at the Wells Fargo Center on Sunday, February 27th at 5 o'clock. And a pair of tickets to see Joe Conklin and the City Rhythm Orchestra on Saturday, February 12th, 8 o'clock at the Broadway Theater in Pittman.
It's time to do a wrap.
All right, real quick. I did share the link again on the WIP Morning Show and Facebook for our coworker, John Gentile. It's a terrible situation. And if anyone can provide a little help, I would be so grateful. Now, Line of the Day is brought to you by AmeriBest Home Healthcare. Don't your loved ones deserve the best home health care? Who better to take care of them than you? Visit AmeriBestHomeCare.com for details.
Imagine that Daryl Morey is holding out hope that Ben would come back onto that floor after he has avoided it all year and created all this drama.
It's unbelievable. You got a better chance of the Flyers winning the Stanley Cup than him playing in Philadelphia again.
Brought to you, it was great. Brought to you by Arm and Cadillac, your Cadillac certified pre-owned headquarters. Visit armandcadillac.com to view their selection of hand-picked certified Cadillacs. Who are you rooting for in the NFC championship game? 55% Rams.
All right, our producer back at station was Mr. Joe Wechter. Our engineer here at Borgata, Dave Breitmeyer, our assistant, Ava Graham. And I do want to wish everybody a safe and healthy weekend. We'll be back on Monday. Go Bengals! How'd we do?
What's a firefighter without a fire truck? Our first responders need reliable equipment. So if you're a mechanic, technician, fabricator, or an assembler, our first responders need you. E1 in Hamburg will give you everything you need to succeed in your career. Tools, full benefits starting from day one, great pay, 401k match, vacations and holidays, and growth opportunities. Register for our on-site hiring event on Thursday, February 17th from 4 to 7 p.m. Visit e1ny.com. That's E-O-N-E-N-Y.com.
Hey, David Bellavia, you get a clean slate for the new year. What about a clean tub? Let Bathfitter give your tub or shower a fresh start with a custom bath solution that fits your space to perfection. It's installed in one day, and it's so easy to clean, you'll volunteer to take on cleaning the entire bathroom. Call Bathfitter 242-8999. Book your free consultation. Tell them Bellavia sent you, and you get up to $1,000 off or no interest financing until 2027. Call Bathfitter at 242-8999.
Now's the time to replace your old fiberglass tub with a Karsten walk-in shower unit or tub surround from Kitchen and Bath Unlimited. Their 7 designers on staff can custom design your shower with exclusive cultured marble materials from Karsten. Let Kitchen and Bath Unlimited help you create the look you want, not the look you have to settle for. Kitchen and Bath Unlimited on Union north of Walden, celebrating over 35 years of beautiful craftsmanship.
Kitchen and Bath Unlimited.
Online at kitchenandbathunlimited.net. Kitchen and Bath Unlimited, where dream bathrooms begin.